All right, welcome everybody. Happy Wednesday. Happy day before Thanksgiving. Happy this day in your life, whatever that happens to be. My thought for you, you know, I thought about a lot of things that I might teach today. And again, it's hard when it's, you know, a big shared event to not go to the automatic things, right? To not have the Dharma be about gratitude or not to have it be about what it always is about. But my thought for you today is, have you actually taken a holiday in the last year? Not do I mean, did you get a day off of work or did you, you know, get to stay home or what? We've all been staying home. But did you actually give yourself a holiday this week, this year at all? Right? Has there been a moment? Has there been a day? Has there been a time where you've let yourself let go of the ongoingness of your life? And have you taken a holiday? Have you let yourself step back from the things that feel like they are consistently pressing in and let yourself feel actual joy for what there still is that's very bright in your life? Have you let yourself do that? Because if you haven't, there is no better time than to find the way to let yourself have that, even in the midst of everything that is continuing to happen, even in the midst of the ongoingness of life. You have to give yourself that experience, because it's not as simple as saying you get the day off, right? Or that you get to do whatever you do as your holiday traditions typically. That's not what makes it a holiday, right? The holiday is, do you let yourself bring to the forefront of your experience that feeling of joy or that feeling of exhilaration or that feeling of even just relief that there's a moment to take a breath, right? Out of the regular routine or out of the regular expectations. Do you give yourself that, right? Because this is what we need. The actual experience going into this holiday season, that there still is a reason to celebrate, that there still are things to be grateful for. There still are things to be giving yourself that permission to be in joy about, right? Because if we don't give that to ourselves, then it won't be there. And it doesn't mean that you negate any other thing that's going on or any other experience, but that you allow for there to be right with that, the knowledge, the experience, the reality, that you're still allowed to take that deep breath and put your cares away for tomorrow. You can pick them up again. And you're still allowed to have big smiles. You're still allowed to be excited. You're still allowed to really celebrate what there is to celebrate, even though, yeah, there's a lot of suffering still in the world. And you will do your part, whatever that is, to continue to elevate the world. But you got to celebrate, and you have to celebrate what's in you that is able to keep doing that day after day after day after day, right? That doesn't get tired, that doesn't break down, that doesn't say, ah, I give up, right? So if you haven't given yourself a holiday this year, give yourself a damn holiday, right? Don't try so hard to be happy in a false way, but to really let yourself find a little smidgen where you take that deep breath, you take that break from whatever your cares are, and you put your mind on something that feels like celebration, right? Because that's better than trying to make yourself feel grateful. That's better than trying to convince yourself that you are participating in some experience in the way that it's always been. Better to actually feel your heart take a deeper breath. Celebrate. And celebrate that there's even the part of you that still knows how to do that, right? So comfortable seat, if you're not there already. Whatever your holiday is going to look like tomorrow or in this coming season, is find those moments that you give yourself permission to feel lighter, even if it's just for an instant. So with the eyes closed, breathe in and out of the heart space. That doesn't just mean that you are inhaling and exhaling into the chest, that's obvious. But the actual feeling that the heart is able to radiate. In the heart center, the Sanskrit for the chakra is anahata, which means it's unstruck. It's a sound, it's a song. But there's no beginning to it and there's no end. Nothing caused it to happen. And therefore, there's nothing that can cause it to cease happening. That's your heart. Right? That's the spiritual joy that we talk about, is that there's a reason to celebrate the fact that you are here, as heavy as it might be. So breathe through that radiance, radiate that. Even if it's non-specific, you breathe through the heart, the unstruck sound. And the point is not to turn sorrow into joy. The point is to allow joy to exist where there is sorrow. The point is to allow there to be a feeling of relief, even though the weight of your life might still be heavy. And to feel time stop for a moment, even though you are in the ongoingness of your life. We call that being present. So breathe through your heart like it's radiating in all directions. This feeling of relief, a feeling of a deep breath. Or just for an instant, whatever your sorrows are, whatever your cares are, they shift to the background. You let yourself feel that there's something to celebrate. One more deep breath, again, breathing, radiating through the heart, not just into the chest, but through the heart. As you exhale, bring the hands together in front of your heart center, palm to palm, and rub your hands together, fast, heat. Go, 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 go. Hands, they say, the arms, the hands are an extension of the heart, so move. Take up heart energy. Good, and then steady the hands at the heart. Good. Feel the heat, feel the resonance, feel the vibration. And we'll open with the sound of Om. Deep breath in. Let the eyes float open. Nice, you guys. You can release your hands, please. Then come forward to hands and knees. We'll start with cat and cow. Meow and moo. Good. So as you start to come onto hands and knees, move with your breath, inhaling, lifting the heart forward beyond the arm. So again, moving through the heart center, not just thinking of your chest, but that there's a radiance, that there is a drawing long of the chest through the arms. And the same thing on the exhale, as though you are lifting up out of your back rib cage, like wings expanding. Good. So move with that, inhaling, dragging the arms back so the chest lifts up, the throat goes long, and then exhaling, curling and rounding. So you're pulling the ribs up between the shoulder blades. Nice. Good, you guys. It's a very interesting thing that I find myself, instead of doing the typical gratitude journal where you're supposed to literally just keep finding things that you're grateful for, and you can do that as a mental exercise, it can be very powerful. But have you tried just going through your day consistently saying, I love you, to the things that matter to you? The stupid things, as well as the really important things. I love you, my cup of coffee that I really enjoy. I love you, my favorite chair that I sit in every day. I love you, my cat that gets in the way of my yoga practice. Go through your day like that, saying, I love you, and see what you feel like. And every time there's worry, you don't push it away, but then you go back to also what's important in front of you. I love you. Good. Nice, you guys. Come back to stillness, please. Plant the hands, tuck your toes, lift the hips to downward facing dog. Good. And then step the right foot forward between the hands. Lunge. Good. Inhale the arms up to the sky. High lunge. And then bring the hands back behind your head, elbows wide. So front knee is over the front ankle. But as your front knee moves, or your front thigh deepens, goes a little deeper towards the floor. So you're not pushing forward into your knee. You're actually moving your pelvis slightly backwards so that you can drop straight down into that deeper lunge. Good. And then twisting to the right keep the hands behind your head. So you keep pushing the head back into the hands. You keep the elbows wide. Good. Back thigh is still pulling up, but you're allowing the pelvis to descend. Good. Nice, you guys. Curl into your navel. One more breath. Twist a little deeper. Yeah. And then come back to center, please. Stretch the arms up to the sky. Good. And then lean forward. Torso parallels the floor. Reach out through the arms. Extend. And again, pull the hips back. So it's like you're moving your weight back into that back leg, but that allows you to scoop your belly, send your right thigh forward more and drop the pelvis a little lower. Yes, good, Laura. And then release the hands down to the floor. Nice job. Both hands inside the front foot, please. Make nice big circles with that hip. If you want to drop the back knee here, you're welcome to. Good. Yeah. Give the back leg a vacation. Nice, you guys. Good. Practicing not trying to change your mind, but to actually let your mind just flow into all the space that it has instead of looking in the same direction over and over again and hoping that it's going to be different this time. Good. Come back to stillness, please. Drop that back knee down to the floor. Scoot your hips back so your left hip is on top of your left knee. Take your right leg forward to straight. Come up on the heel. Ardha Hanumanasana. Good. Hands can frame the front foot, or you can keep both hands to the inside of the front thigh. Your choice. Good. Then you're turning your belly just a little bit towards the right so that the top of your left hip is spinning slightly forward. Good. So it means the top of your right hip is able to go wider to the right. And then you're walking your hands forward, drag that heel back and bow. Again, moving from the heart center with the heart center. So if your back is curling here, if it's rounding a ton between your shoulder blades, maybe lift yourself up a little bit higher. Yeah, get more space through the heart and then extend from there. Nice. And it might be increased sensation. That's the crazy thing is you start to actually say, I want the space of my heart to be more open. Well, you'll feel more and not all of it's going to be pleasant, but having the space to feel more means that you never get stuck in that place that says that I'm too small to hold what I feel. You keep expanding with the experience. Good. One more breath. Nice. And then slide that heel back, please. Bend the knee again. Come forward to Anjaneyasana. So back knee stays on the floor, but bring your right knee forward over the ankle or slightly beyond, and then take the arms up to the sky. Good. Feel your inner thighs pushing wide, both legs. Good. And then lifting the low belly, take the hands behind your head again. Elbows wide, lift the chest a little higher, lean back just a tiny bit. So again, you get that full openness through the front of the chest, through the back of the heart, send your pelvis forward. Good. And then come back to upright, please. Arms to the sky. Bring your left forearm onto your front thigh, please. Bring your right hand to your lower back, twisting to the right. Good. So pressing into that forearm means that your left shoulder stays awake. So you're not just leaning all of your weight forward, but you're pushing into that forearm. Keep the left side body open and then twist that left shoulder around. Bring the rib cage around. Nice. Then either keep the hand at the low back, pushing the sacrum up into your hand, or take the right arm over your ear, reaching on the diagonal. Good. Either way, I still want you to have that little backwards feeling of pulling the sacrum back as though your hand is there. Good. Right rib cage draws in. So left rib cage pushes wide. That's your lower ribs. Good. Come all the way back up to center. Arms up. Inhale. Yeah. Did you get taller there or not? Pull up. There you go. Good, Harriet. And then release the hands down to the floor. Lift the back knee, please. Good. Take that right leg up and back down. Dog split. Good, you guys. Bend the knee. Kick your heel in towards your butt. Keep your knee pointing down towards the floor. So you got to scoop into your low belly a little more. And then arms pull up into the shoulder socket. Lift the back of your throat. Lift the back of your heart. That scorpion position, keep pulling up through the right thigh and squeeze the heel in. Good. Nice. Ribs in. So you're still trying to bring your tail almost towards that back heel. So you're not totally arching the lower back. Awesome. And then release the head, stretch the leg straight back behind you, down dog split, pull. Good. And then release that foot down to the floor. Nice job. Deep breath in, deeper breath out. Good. And then left foot steps forward between the hands. Inhale the arms to the sky, high lunge. Good. Front knee, again, moving over the front ankle, but allowing it to do that not by pushing your weight forward towards the front of your foot or pushing into that front part of your knee. I want you to actually pull the low belly back just a little bit and then let your pelvis descend straight down, right? Your knee will move forward. Good. Nice, you guys. Hands behind your head. Twisting to your left, so towards the front leg. Keep the elbows wide. Good. Watch that your front knee doesn't fall in, so you're pushing the inner thigh wide, anchoring the big toe. Good. Squeeze those shoulder blades towards the back of your heart. So not towards each other, but towards the back of the heart. Nice. And then come back to center, please. Inhale, arms up. Take your torso forward, parallel to the floor. As your weight comes forward with the torso, pull your hips back. Good. So again, your knee is not just taking all of that forward momentum. You're actually pulling the hips back. Nice. And then release the hands down to the floor. Both hands inside the front foot. Make nice big circles with that hip. Again, you can drop the back knee if that feels more accessible. How much room do you make for enjoyment? I know I've said it 1,000 times to you guys, but I'll probably say it 1,000 more, that this concept of being in a body is referred to, right, as the path of enjoyment, right? Being in a body means that all of the emotional experiences, physical experiences, that that's all categorized as enjoyment. So when we accept things for what they are without trying to change them, we get a little bit more of that. Good. Come back to stillness, please. Drop that back knee. Shift your right hip back in space, so it's on top of the knee. Take the left leg forward to straight, come up on the heel. Ardha Hanumanasana. Good. So again, setting the right knee so it's right underneath the right hip. If you're slightly forward, you're gonna feel more stretch in that right leg, but that's not necessarily the point, right? Give the pelvis a little vacation here, as you want it to be nice and neutral so that the stretch is really just focused on the left leg, the extended leg. Good. Again, hands can frame the foot or be on the inside. Walk the hands forward a little bit more. Inner thighs push wide. Good. Breathe the whole length of your spine. If your upper back is rounding a ton, lift up higher. Good. And again, radiate from the sternum. Pull the sternum forward and feel that there's an extension of what your heart is able to feel that is shared. Right? The heart is also said, the quality of the heart center is air. That's the element. And one of the characteristics of that is that if you allow air to enter a container, is it will evenly distribute it itself over time. It will evenly distribute itself in that container. So the heart intermingles. That's what it does. And over time, if you allow it, it will intermingle with the hearts of all other beings. And part of your mind just said, oh, I don't want to do that. So don't think about the other beings. Just think about being intermingled, the support that comes with that. Good. Drag that heel back in, please. I know you think that was a long hold. It wasn't. Bring your knee forward, Anjaneyasana. Good. Back knee stays on the floor. Root through that front heel. Inhale the arms up to the sky. Good. Again, the belly draws back. Take your hands behind your head. Good. Feeling the space of the heart. So squeeze the inner elbows in slightly and then lift the chest up, up, up from your armpits. Pull up, up, up and let your pelvis again move forward and down as you pull the belly back and up, chest up and wide. Good. So Emily, let your head fall back a little more. You can. Yeah. Nice, you guys. And then come all the way back up, arms to the sky. Right forearm comes onto front shin, or sorry, not front shin, front thigh. Left hand comes to your lower back. Good, twisting to your left. So push into that right forearm. So again, you don't collapse into the front shoulder. You keep it lifted, right rib cage lifted. And then either keep the left hand there, pushing the sacrum back into that hand so you don't get stuck in your hip creases, or take the left arm over the ear, reach on the diagonal. Good, keep pushing your inner thighs wide so that you're stable. Good. Nice, you guys. Right rib cage pushes wider to the right. So Lisa S, push it wider. Good. Nice, Joanne. And then come back to center, arms up to the sky. Good, pull up taller. Uh-huh. And then release the hands down. Nice job. Lift the back knee, take your left leg up and back, down dog split. Good. And then bend the knee, kick your heel in towards your butt, keep the knee pointing down. Good, pull your arms up into the shoulder socket so your chest is gonna feel like it's coming slightly forward, but wide, it's gonna feel really wide. And then lifting that thigh up, lift the back of your head up, the back of your heart up. Good, and keep pulling the arms back, keep pulling the arms up. Good, to expand the chest. It doesn't matter how big the back bend is. Expand your chest, expand the space behind the heart. Good, Alice, pull your hip creases back more so you're still in that down dog. There you go. Awesome, you guys. And then drop the head, straighten the leg back behind you, extend. Nice, drop the left foot down to the floor. Deep breath in, deeper breath out. Drop the knees to the floor, please. Child's pose. What's really more important, right? So I know tomorrow is a big shared holiday, but what's more important is that my birthday is coming up on the 1st. So I won't see you again before then. So you have to remember on Tuesday to celebrate my birthday. Don't forget. Walk your torso to the right, please. And if you can't think of the best way to celebrate my birthday, it's probably eating cake in a handstand. If you can do that, that's probably the way to do it. Yeah, maybe not at the same time. Walk yourself back to center, go to the left. But the other way would be to spend the entire day saying, I love you to the things that matter to you. Just don't abandon your sense of enjoyment of the world simply because it's not easily accessible. It's not easily being shoved in your face. Come back to center. Good. And then walk yourself back up, please, to hands and knees. Good. Take the right leg back behind you, toes tucked on the floor. Drop the heel flat. Right hand comes to your right hip. Good. So you can go ahead and stretch that right arm up to the sky just for fun, just for a moment. So you get that full open stretch through the chest. Watch what your left shoulder is doing to hold you here. So you want the left arm bone to rotate wide, draw your ribs in. Good. And then take that right arm over the ear, extend. Nice, super long. And then let your weight move forward over that left wrist. Your left armpit pulls forward, press into your left shin, float your right leg up parallel to the floor. And again, the arm can stay over the ear or come back up to the sky if that feels better. Good. Lift that inner thigh a little higher, you guys. Yes. There you go, Lisa. Good. And then bend the knee, kick your heel back towards your butt, reach back for the foot or the ankle, or stay where you are. Nice. But if you're reaching for that foot, you've still got to lift the inner thigh higher. You still got to stack that hip and pull your heel towards the middle of your butt cheek. So don't let it go up towards the sky. Pull it in and lift the inner thigh. Nice, Mark. Good. And then extend all the way back out. Reach. Haha. And then take it all the way back down, hands and knees. Good job. Deep breath in. Deeper breath out. Left leg back behind you, please. Drop the heel flat. Good. Take the left arm up to the sky. So take the open twist first. Noticing what the lower arm, what your right arm is doing to hold you. If that shoulder is falling forward, adjust it. Maybe even rotate your hand so that it's able to open a little bit more. So find both sides of your chest. Good. Now take the left arm over the ear. This is the thing, is if we don't find the space in us, is there's no guarantee that it's going to be directed at us or given to us. You have to do it. Slide your weight forward a little bit more, right armpit over right wrist, press into your right shin. Left leg comes up parallel to the floor. Good. So if you didn't set your shoulder before putting your weight on it, guess what? You're going to have a stuck shoulder that's now bearing weight. Nice. Lift that inner thigh a little higher. There's your outer hip. Good job. Bend the knee, kick your heel in towards your butt, reach back for the foot or the ankle. Yeah, you got it. Nice, Sue. Nice, Lisa. Again, you're drawing that heel slightly in towards the middle of your sacrum, so or towards the middle of that left butt cheek. So your inner thigh is going to actually rotate slightly forward and you get to stack your hips open a little bit more. Notice I said you get to. Good. And then extend all the way back out. Nice job. Nice. And then come all the way back to hands and knees. Do a little hip circling. Good. Move your hips the other way. Beautiful. And then come back to center, please. Nice job. Downward facing dog. Good. Right foot steps forward between the hands. Lunge. Drop the back heel. Baby toe parallels the back of your mat. Warrior two. Cartwheel the arms up. Shoulders over your hips. Virabhadrasana two. Good. Watch where your front knee is pointing. So you move it a little bit wider towards the baby toe. There you go, Andy. Good. Drop the left hand down the back thigh. Right palm spins up and back. Reverse warrior. Nice. And then come all the way back up, warrior two. Good. Take the right arm back up to the sky, straight up. Left hand holds your right wrist. Good. Now pull towards the back of your mat, reverse warrior. Yeah. Notice if it's different, if you're reaching for the back leg as opposed to just reaching through your right side body. So again, lift your right hip point a little higher towards the top of your mat. Let your right thigh go deeper. I know you've been in the lunge for a while. Don't get tired. Good. And then come all the way back up, warrior two. Awesome. And then straighten the front thigh, please. Reach your hands back behind you, interlace the fingers at the low spine. Good, stretch the arms towards straight and then turn your left rib cage towards the back of your mat. So don't spin forward, turn it wide. Good, and you're still rotating that front thigh in the opposite direction. So your knee is gonna continue to point towards second or third toe. Triangle pose, you're keeping the legs straight. You can look forward. Lean the torso forward, right rib cage comes towards the front thigh. But keep pulling your hands at the diagonal towards your back heel and rotate your left rib cage up towards the sky. So get into the twist of triangle. Good. I know it's the what should be the most fun part of triangle, but we don't focus on it. So Mark, left rib cage up towards the sky. Yeah, turn your heart to the sky. Turn your belly to the side. Throat back. Yes. Now let the arms extend out, right hand down to the floor, left arm up to the sky. Good. And rotate your ribs even more because now you have no excuse. Good. And don't get me wrong. We can come up with plenty of excuses. Good. One more breath. Open. Pull through that left arm. Pull through that wideness of your left ribs. Awesome. Bend the front knee. Release the hands down to the floor. Good. Spin the back heel up and then drop that back knee, please. Yep. Walk your hands up to the front thigh or to blocks. Nice. So you're dragging that back knee down and forward, lifting your low belly. See if you can lift your foot off of the floor without using your hands. Just squeeze the heel in and pull up through the low space of your belly. I know. Good. You got it, Kristen. Good. One more breath. Arms to the sky or hands behind your head. Even better. Heart up. Yeah. Like you're going to just grab that foot behind you, but you're not. Beautiful. You are lifting your back foot and then slowly release. Now that Carolina finally figured out what we were doing. Hands to the floor, please. Good. Lift the back knee. Good. And then take your right leg up and back behind you. Down dog split. Yeah. Nice, you guys. Walk your hands back towards that left foot. Oh no, I've been into that transition lately. I like it for standing split. Don't worry, you know I'll do it for a while and then I'll forget about it. I'll go on to something else. Deep breath in. Good. And then walk yourself forward again to down dog split. So keep the leg lifted. Beautiful. And then step it forward between the hands again, still right foot forward. Drop the back knee. Come back to Ardha Hanumanasana. So bringing the left hip back on top of the knee, taking the right heel down, toes up. then pause here for a moment, deep breath in. And then go a little deeper, either into full Hanuman, so extend that right heel further forward, wiggle your left leg back, or just let yourself go any amount towards that full pose, even if you're not going to push for the whole kit and caboodle. Good. And again, you're not holding for a long time, so don't, you know, move into wherever your suffering mind likes to go to. Good. One more breath. Awesome. And then pull yourself back in, please. Come back to downward facing dog. Not so bad. Maybe you disagree. You're entitled. Good. Slide forward to plank pose, please. Upward push up. Lower down slow to your belly, coming through knees first if you need. Rise up cobra. Head, neck, and chest. Elevate your mind. Heart forward between the arms. Good. And then come back downward facing dog, please. From the back of your heart, get wide. Nice. Left foot steps forward between the hands. Good. Drop the back heel. Baby toe parallels back of your mat. Come into warrior two. Shoulders over the hips. Arms wide. Good. Again, watching where the front knee is pointing. Yep. Second or third toe. Good. And then right hand drops down the back thigh, left palm spins up and back, reverse warrior. Feeling that the back thigh is lifting up into your hand, right? That concept that you can constantly be elevating yourself if you remember to. Good. Come back up to warrior two. Nice. And then stretch the left arm back up to the sky. Reach with your right hand to hold your left wrist and then pull to the back of your mat. So now again, adding your own effort to the stretch, how does it change it? And if it feels like you're just pulling your left arm out of your shoulder, well, pull that arm bone back in and feel your ribs extend a little bit more. Reach through your ribs from the top of your left hip point, lift up. Good. And let your thighs go a little deeper into the lunge. So Emily, knee forward a little bit more. That's it. Come all the way back up to center. Good job, you guys. Arms wide. Straighten the front thigh, making sure that when you do that, your knee doesn't rotate completely in. Make sure that it's still in the same orientation. Take your hands back behind you. Interlace your fingers at the low spine. Good. Hug the upper arms. Take the arms towards straight. Watch that your ribs don't push out. And then lean the left rib cage forward towards triangle, what feels like triangle. But I want you to focus on the twisting of the trunk here. So you're pulling your right rib cage up and back, and you're letting your left rib cage really curl under so that you get that feeling of rotation of the ribs. And the pelvis is holding you steady. So squeeze the feet towards each other. Keep lifting the right rib cage. Keep opening the heart towards the sky. And every aspect of this is part of enjoyment. So don't exclude it. Good. And then release the hands, left hand down, right arm to the sky. Good. Again, widening through the chest, through the upper back. And maybe using that right hand, that right arm as a way to visualize pulling up and opening the right rib cage even more. Good. Opening the right hip even more. Breathe through your heart, not just into your lungs, but through your heart. Be in the world through that heart space, not just through your mind, what it perceives. Good. Bend the left knee, please. Release the hands down to the floor. Good. Spin your back heel up. Drop that back knee. Good. Anjaneyasana. Inhale the arms up to the sky. Good. Again, blanket underneath the knee if you need. And then without reaching back for the foot, can you drag that back thigh down and forward? Do the dragging first so that you've got that lift through your belly. Can you squeeze that heel in towards your butt? Good. So you lift the foot like into the quad stretch, but you're not reaching for the foot. Nice. And then take your hands behind your head, please. Good. Take the heart higher. Lean back as though, again, you can reach for that quad stretch, but you're not going to reach for the foot. Good. I know. And then slowly release, please. Foot to the floor, hands to the floor. Nice job, you guys. Scoot your scoot your butt back. Ardha Hanumanasana. So move your right hip back in space. I think I'm changing the order here, but that's okay. We'll get to everything. Good. I know if we thought you were going to celebrate that, I was going to just leave out standing split or something. Nope. Good, you guys. Good. Drag that heel back in because I do think that I did this out of order. So lift the back knee up. Come back to down dog split. So take that left leg up and back behind you. Yeah. And then walk your hands back towards your right foot. So come into standing split. And I think I recall that I did it this way because I wanted you to work the split action first before I asked you to go into Hanuman. So feel the wideness, the pulling the thighs apart and turn those left toes down. Turn your left hip down towards the floor. So Harriet, left hip turns down, baby toe turns down. That's it. Good. And then walk yourself forward again, back to down dog split. Nice. And then left foot steps forward between the hands one more time. Dropping the back knee, again, either coming back to Ardha Hanumanasana or going for any version of a deeper Hanuman, taking the left heel forward more, wiggling the right knee back. You can lift the back knee up. It's one of my favorite ways to do Hanuman. And again, you're not holding for a long time, so don't settle into wherever your mind usually goes about what you don't like about Hanumanasana. What is there to celebrate in this moment? The lift of your chest, the strength of your thighs. Wherever you are, put your mind in a place that is accepting that there can be more than just what I don't like. Good. Pull yourself all the way back up and in. Really nice, you guys. Come back to downward facing dog. Good. Slide forward to plank pose, upward push up. Lower down slow, coming through knees first if you need. Rising up into cobra, lift head, neck, and chest. Again, dragging back on the hands. So again, it's the heart coming forward. It's the chest moving forward. And then release downward facing dog. Good, you guys. Slide forward to plank again, please. Lower back down to your belly. And then come into Sphinx pose, coming up onto the forearms. And pressing down and dragging back. Good. Again, breathing through the chest, through the heart center. Idea that there is nothing that needs to jumpstart an experience of appreciation or gratitude or joy. That's what we hear all the time. And we're just trying to trigger it in ourselves because it's there already. So we're told in the teachings is that state is in you already. It's part of you already. But we have to exit out the door of our mind only looking at what is difficult or challenging or what we label as our suffering. We have to allow there to be a intermingling. That one experience does not negate the other. So how often do you give yourself permission to feel that? That you are the one who has to make that decision. It's your mind. Good. Pressing into the forearms, please round your back, look towards your belly button so you puff up through the lower rib cage. Good. Tuck your toes, please, and then lift up into a forearm plank. Yeah. Good. And then once you're there, right, the low ribs stay puffed up, but then lift your collarbones forward and up. Again, drag back on your elbows, sternum up. So you breathe through the wideness of the back of your heart, the front of your heart, inner thighs up. So Alice, inner thighs a little higher. There you go. Nice. Now walk your feet forward towards your elbows. Lift your butt. Dolphin pose. Good. The head can drop, absolutely, but keep pressing into your forearms. Keep pulling your thighs up and back, even if it means your knees bend slightly. Pull through the spine. Good. And then those of you who are pretty comfortable there, take one leg up to the sky. Nice. Good, Lisa. Nice, Emily. And then release that foot down. Take the other leg up to the sky because it might be your second favorite, but it's still your favorite. Good. And then release that leg down to the floor. Beautiful. Drop the knees to the floor, please. And come to sit on your, well, take a child's pose first. Breathe in child's pose for a minute. Not even a minute. 30 seconds. Good. And then come to sit back either on your heels or between your heels. Taking the right arm up to the sky. Bend the elbow, place the hand behind your heart, and then left hand comes up just to hold the tip of the elbow. So you're just stretching through the arm. Good. And dropping your seat. Nice. Draw your head back a little bit more, Lisa, so it's in line with your spine. Good. And then release and switch. Bend the left elbow, hand behind the heart, right hand comes to hold. Again, drawing the ribs in, dropping your seat so that, again, we're getting a whole stretch through the left side. Not shortening it by letting the ribs pop forward. Good. And then slowly release, hands back down to the floor. Nice. Walk yourself forward again, back to hands and knees. And come back to downward facing dog. Good. Step your right foot forward between the hands. Walk your fingertips slightly forward. Lift up to standing split. So left leg comes parallel to the floor. Good, hands touching something. So make sure if you can't touch the floor, you have blocks or something underneath your hands. Good, so you can come up on the tippy toes of your right foot, lift the heel, dropping into your hands. Again, bending the elbows just a little bit. So don't scare yourself, but bend your elbows, let your chest drop. So you feel your arms, your shoulders move onto the back and then hug those upper arms like now you're in a push-up. Good, and then push the floor away from your chest. Good. And then maybe take a little kick up towards handstand. What? I know. Nice. Beautiful. You just did all that work to set your arms. You got to do something beautiful with it. Good. Even if you're not kicking, you're doing something beautiful with it. Awesome, you guys. And then slowly release. Step it all the way back. Nice long lunge. Inhale the arms up to the sky. High lunge. Good. So if you don't know what just happened, you're on high lunge with the right knee forward. Hands to heart center, prayer twist, left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Good, and again, just like in that triangle pose, work from your rib cage. So your left rib cage is allowing, it's tucking under so that your right rib cage can draw back and up towards the sky. So move your heart from the center of you. And then again, breathe through that heart center. Don't get stuck in your belly. Don't get stuck in your chest. Breathe the whole expansion front and back. Awesome. And then come back to center, arms to the sky, because it's important, release the twist, and then take the hands back down to the floor. Beautiful. And then step back downward facing dog. Nice. Vinyasa if you'd like, child's pose if you prefer, or stay in dog. If you're doing the vinyasa, you're sliding forward to plank, lowering down slow, rising up into cobra. Again, heart forward, pull forward, pull forward, pull forward, armpits back, downward facing dog. Wherever you are. Good. Left foot steps forward between the hands, lunge. Walk the fingertips straight ahead, step up to standing split, right thigh parallels the floor. Again, finding something underneath your hands. Good. And then you're coming up on the ball of your left foot, so lift your left heel. That's so that you let your weight drop forward. This is the point, right? Is maybe that doesn't feel like it's super comfortable, but let your weight fall forward onto your hands. And then bend your elbows just a little bit so that you feel the arms pull into the shoulder socket, whether you like it or not. And then hug those upper arms towards each other, squeeze, try and feel your armpits engage. And then as you start to push the floor away, feel that happen from your chest and upper back. Good, keep the arms hugging, don't lock the elbows. And then play with scooping the belly, kicking a little bit up towards handstand. Good, nice, Emily. And you're leading with that lifted leg. That's the crazy thing when you kick up into handstand. The leg that's already in the air is the one that's leading you. So you gotta lift that right inner thigh higher. Good. And then slowly come back down to earth. Really nice, Alice. Nice job, you guys. Step back, nice long lunge. So left leg is forward, right leg is back. Arms to the sky, high lunge. Got your heart rate up, didn't I? Yeah. Hands to heart center, please. Right elbow to the outside of the left knee, prayer twist. Good. Nice, you guys. Left rib cage is lifting up. Right rib cage is rotating around, so don't leave that part out. chest open. So squeeze those armpits towards each other, Lisa. So it's going to lift your chest a little higher. There you go. Good. Come back to center, arms to the sky. It's okay, Debbie. You really had that. Good. And then take the hands back down to the floor. Awesome job. Step back, downward facing dog. Nice. And then drop down to the knees, please. Child's pose. Good. All right, bring yourself back up to hands and knees, please. Drop down onto your forearms. So on your knees and on your elbows. Good. Tucking the toes, lifting the hips, coming back to that forearm dog. Yeah, pressing down and dragging back. Feet scoot forward any amount. Take your right leg up to the sky. And now pull up and in, bring the back of your heart up, bend that right knee, kick your heel in towards your butt. Good, lift through that thigh, pull those arms up towards the heart and lift the chest slightly forward. Good, a little deeper scorpion than what we did before. And just keep dragging in, that's the thing, is keep pulling the arms towards the center of the chest. Good, keep widening. Nice. Extend that leg back. Drop the head, please. Release that foot down to the floor. Drop down for a moment just to remind yourself that you're not stuck in this position. And then try the other side. Come back up onto the forearms. Tuck the toes. Lift the hips. Left leg comes up to the sky. Good. Bend the knee. Kick your heel in towards your butt. So that thigh has to be really active. So your hips are doing the work of keeping themselves lifted. Press into your forearms. Drag the arm bones up and in as you take your chest slightly forward. Wide, wide, wide through the chest and through the upper back. Good. The head can continue to hang if you just work from the upper back, because the head will go with you. But craning the neck is not going to open your back more. Good. Pull those arms up and in, Joanne. So it's like you're dropping your chest towards the floor a little more. Good, you guys. And then extend the leg back. Good. Drop that foot down to the floor. Nice. Drop the knees. Child's pose. I was strongly considering giving you the option to kick up into forearm balance there. Maybe you'll do that for my birthday. Good. Slowly walk yourself back up, please. Come to sit on your butt. Take your legs out in front of you. Good. Right leg extends out. Bend the left knee in towards your chest and then let your knee go wide, bottom of the foot to the inside of the right leg. Good. Inhale the arms up to the sky. Little twist to your right and then bow over the right thigh. Janu Shirshasana. Head to knee pose. Good. Keep turning your left rib cage slightly forward. So it's going to allow space for the right side to expand. So we use that term over and over, allowing things to occur. And that's really what it is. Is it's finding where there is permission to feel more than what seems like it is the necessary thing to feel. But can you expand your awareness to include everything that you feel? And that's one of the ways that we start to give ourselves permission to feel okay or even to feel happy in moments where there's still great sorrow. We can still celebrate even though things are not the way we might want them to be. It's said that that never ending, never beginning, never ending source of rising energy, uplifting energy, elevating energy is that that's your soul shining through. That's what we're told. That's the God essence shining through. but you have to allow it to. There's a scene in the Ramayana where Ram's wife, who's been kidnapped by a demon, she's, you know, being held captive, and you think, oh, how horrible that must be. And it is. She's having a terrible experience. You wonder what her prison looks like. It's the most beautiful garden in existence. She's held captive in a beautiful garden. An Ashoka garden, Ashoka trees, which in Sanskrit translates to without sorrow. Walk yourself back up. Take your left hand back behind you, behind your hip. Press into your left shin, lift your butt up off the floor so your right foot comes to the floor. Sweep the right arm up and over the ear so you're lifting up on the left shin, extending through that right leg. You got it, right arm comes over the ear. Let your chest fall open to the sky. Don't just lean through the side body. That's it, Lisa. Nice, Joanne. Nice, Alice. Nice, Emily. Nice, Harriet. Good, Andy. Good, Laura. Nice, Debbie. And then slowly bring it all the way back down, please. Good. And then switch your seat. Take the left leg forward. Bend your right knee. Bring it in. Bottom of the foot to the inside of the left leg. Let your knee go wide. Arms up. Little twist to the left. And bow forward. Yeah. And again, I'm giving you time here on purpose, not just to be in a forward fold, but to actually allow your spine to continue to release and extend. To get out of the state of I'm here for a limited time that is painful, maybe, depending on how your body feels, and that's all I'm here for, that's the expectation. I'm going to feel what I always feel here, and then I'm going to exit. So I want you to stay, and I want you to keep rotating. Can I draw my right low belly, my right hip slightly forward so that I release the left side a little more? The longer I'm here, can I expand my awareness away from where I habitually focus on? And can I feel something more? Can I stay rooted in breathing through my heart center, experiencing through my heart center, instead of letting my mind tune out to go somewhere else? I love that scene. Is Sita weeping and weeping and weeping over the sorrow of her life and the suffering that she's going through. But at the same time, she's in a garden, a beautiful garden, named for there being no sorrow. So can you feel the experience of both intermingled? Because this is the heart. This is what it really means to be in your heart center, is that you are intermingled with the rest of the world. And so, yeah, there's a lot to feel there, and not all of it pleasant. But by denying yourself that or closing it off, you make it harder to bear. You make it harder to bear what you think is yours instead of sharing it. So we're asked to have an open heart so that there is that quality of intermingled support. We're asked to feel everything because that makes everything bearable. So give yourself permission to feel more than just what is difficult. Walk yourself back up. Good, right hand comes back behind you, right hand behind your hip. Lift up onto your right shin, please. Take your hips up off the floor, left foot finds the floor. Sweep your left arm up over the ear. Again, so it's a side body stretch, but it's also the opportunity to keep rotating your heart center towards the sky, almost like you are gonna turn this into a modified like way to get back into wheel. Right? So you're turning it into more of a back bend, stretching open. Really nice, Joanne. Good. You're stretching open through the ribs, through the chest. Good, Debbie. Awesome, Kristen. Nice, Sue. And then slowly release. Come back to center, please. Good job. Bring the bottoms of the feet together. Let your knees go wide. Baddha Konasana. Good. And then holding underneath the ankles, pull up. So you get your shoulders a little awake, pull up. So you're pulling your shins up. Press your baby toes down, but pull your shins up. You might even feel your knees squeeze up a little bit. Good. And then as you bow forward, bend your elbows out wide, chest wide. So as you lean forward, you have that openness through the chest, but also engaged. Good. So don't let your head fall forward. Don't let your shoulders round forward. Even though your elbows are bent, pull wide. You got it. Nice, you guys. And keep pulling the elbows wide, even if that means you don't go very far forward. So you get more into your spine. Good. And then slowly release, come all the way back up. Good, stretch your legs out wide. Maybe not as wide as you always go, so slightly in. Then with the legs out wide, dig the heels down, pull back so that your knees pop up so you have bent knees. Good, but your heels are down and your toes are not falling in or out. They're straight up and down, so inner thighs still rotate down. Good, and then start to walk yourself forward, keeping the knees bent, giving a little hug between the feet, a little hug between the thighs. Good, send your groins back. Nice, and those of you who come pretty close to the floor here, if you wanna thread each arm underneath your raised knee, so right arm goes underneath the right leg, left arm goes underneath the left leg, you can go for that. So again, dropping the chest towards the floor, but staying really wide. Good, and then if you are there, if you wanna start to wiggle your feet closer towards each other, towards the top of your head, good, opportunity. Again, you gotta come real low to be able to eventually get so deep inside that forward fold that you can cross the feet over your head. And then maybe even bend your elbows underneath your thighs and reach around to hold your fingers at your low back. So they call this tortoise pose. A little homage to Ram, Vishnu. Good. And then slowly release wherever you are. Nice job, Alice. Beautiful, you guys. Keep the legs wide. Turn your belly towards the right thigh, one hand on either side of the leg, and then just walk yourself straight forward. Again, as you walk forward, stretching through the left side, so the left thigh presses down, your left butt cheek presses down. Good, so you get more stretch through your left side body. Nice, and then come all the way back up, please. And switch to the other side, turning towards the left leg, one hand on either side. And bow straight ahead. Good, turning your right hip, right side torso forward a little bit more. So even more, try and turn from the low place of your waist, twist. Other way. There you go. Nice, you guys. And then walk yourself back up, please. Beautiful. Good. Scoot yourself forward, please. Come onto your backs. If you have a block, bring a block with you. So placing a block underneath the sacrum, if you would like, knees bent. So supported bridge. And if you don't have a block, you can rest in constructive rest with the hips on the floor and the knees bent, or you can come into bridge without the block. You just might not hold as long. So you're here, you're in a supported pose. Let the block support you. You actually allow your weight to settle. Allow the thigh bones to feel like they are drawing in towards the hip socket. Allow the chest to fall open however it's going to fall. Allow the throat to elongate. Good, try not to let your knees fall all the way open because that's not gonna help. But can you allow for there to be a sharing of the weight that you carry? Because we do this, especially when we care, when we're caring human beings. When we care, we start carrying a lot of weight that's not always even having anything to do with us. And so it said, yeah, you are intermingled with the whole world, but you are not responsible for the whole world. What you do have the power to do is to navigate your own path, the space that is immediately around you. What do you radiate into that? What do you intermingle into that? And if you want to see more celebration in the world, well, then you yourself have to give permission to celebrate. So So amongst all of your places where you have tremendous cares, tremendous weight in your life, I know you do, we all do. Can you also find the moment where you allow your heart to be light? Because that will make the rest of it bearable. So if you have forgotten already to try and breathe through the heart, go back to it. What does it feel like to breathe through the heart center? Where you intermingle this thread of unexplainable joy, simply that you are alive. You intermingle that with everything else that's running through your mind, through your body, through your experience. It's not separate from. And you let yourself be held, let your weight settle. Good. A couple more breaths. And press into your feet, lift your hips up off of the block, place the block to the side. Slowly lower the hips back down to the floor. Remind yourself on days when your back is sore that you have that block and you are perfectly able and capable and allowed to do supported bridge, even if I didn't tell you to. Remind yourself. Right ankle over left thigh, please. Lift your left shin parallel to the floor, reach through to hold. Good. Right, and the story is the character that kind of is that unadulterated joy, unapologetic joy, is Krishna. Because even when the world's at war and everything is falling apart, he still dances and sings. Because he's the voice of the soul, he's the voice of the heart that says, that's never, your heart's never not singing. You just can't always hear it. Place that left foot back down to the floor, please. Keep the ankle crossed, step your left foot a little wider to the left, drop your knees to the right. Good. If having the ankle on top of the knee here does not feel good, then step it down off of that knee and just let the twist happen without the added weight. And in the story is Krishna, who is always calling us away from the mundane routine aspect of our lives. He says, don't forget, right, that you're a soul with a body. He's always calling us away from that experience of excluding our joyful self. Plays hide and seek. Come back up to center, please. Good. Take your right foot down to the floor, left ankle on right thigh. Lift your shin, reach through to hold. And so the milkmaids who he is always dancing with, there's one moment he'll be dancing with them and then he disappears and they go crazy trying to find him, running all over the place, wondering where he went. And his big joke is he says, I hide in the one place that they will never look, their own heart. So it's intermingled there, that unapologetic joy. And says, no matter, it does not matter that there is suffering, there is also joy. Not attached to any person, place, or thing. But you can trigger it by many people, places, and things. Good. Release the leg, please. Right foot steps down to the floor. Move your heel or move your right foot wider to the right. Drop the knees to the left. Again, keeping the ankle stacked if you'd like, or if that weight does not feel good on the knee or the hip, you can certainly step it down. Give yourself a true celebration this season, somewhere, somehow. You give your mind a break from carrying the weight of the world. even if it's just the weight of your own little world. Good. Slowly unwind, come back to center. Hug the knees in towards your chest. Come into happy baby, draw the knees wide, reach for your ankles, insteps. Good. And then squeezing the knees back in towards your chest. Bring your forehead up to meet your knees. Hug, hug, hug. And then releasing, taking the legs out in front of you, arms alongside you. Settle for Shavasana. Maybe practicing again that concept of radiating through the heart, breathing your experience through the heart center and intermingling with the energy, the heart energy of others, even if you don't know who they are or what's going on. Just opening windows, opening doors. Very gently bring the awareness back to your breath, letting the body begin to stretch, move, in whatever ways serve it well. And as you're ready, draw your knees in towards your chest, roll to your right side, and take a moment there before you begin to push the floor away. Come back to an upright seated position. Bringing the hands together in front of the heart center, palm to palm, or whatever mudra has been serving you well. So the states of joy and gratitude and bliss and all the things that yoga promises are within us. They say they're ubiquitous, they're universal, they're always happening, but our mind isn't always looking that direction. So we have to trigger it. We have to find something that brings us back to that awareness that there is celebration, that there is enjoyment, even amongst whatever it is that we're struggling with or suffering with. And so holidays are a way to jumpstart that. We sing, we dance, this is Krishna. We sing, we dance, we eat, we do whatever we do, we play. And that helps to jumpstart your awareness that that still lives in you. So don't deprive that. Don't deprive yourself of that. Even if things don't look the way that they normally do, give yourself a freaking holiday and really feel it. Give yourself permission to really feel it for what it is and what it isn't. But feel it. I guarantee it will make the rest of the year, the rest of the upcoming year, more bearable. You keep that, you intermingle it. So the heart stays open to feel. And if the heart is open, then joy will be there. If it's not, and you're looking elsewhere, you'll see everything but that. So jumpstart it. We'll close with the sound of Om. Deep breath in. Sliding the thumbs up to the space between the eyebrows. Namaste, everybody. Thank you guys so, so much. Have a great rest of your night, a great rest of your week. If I don't see you, have a great holiday tomorrow. Cheryl is teaching tomorrow, 9:30 a.m. If you are interested in that, no in studio, only on Zoom, but it's free. So you don't have to sign in on Wix. You just show up on Zoom, bring friends, bring family, bring whoever you want if they want to practice with you. So that is the only class tomorrow. And then Friday and weekend is regular schedule. Okay.